Hello, my name is Dragos, and in this video I'd like to show you how you can configure your short pixel adapting image plugin with a custom CDN from bunny.net. So bunny.net, it's a CDN that it's relatively cheap. It can help you speed up your WordPress website with just a couple of dollars a year. I have it set up in several of my websites and it's really inexpensive. It has 50 edge locations, and in this tutorial I will show you how you can utilize it with the Short Pixel Adaptive Image plugin. The Short Pixel Adaptive Image plugin, let me open it. This is the plugin. It's a plugin that it helps you process the images on your WordPress website dynamically. It resizes them, it shrinks them, it converts them into WebP format automatically. So it does everything for you, and also it serves them from their CDN. If you checked right now, this is the plugin, Short Pixel AI Adaptive Images. It's installed, it's configured here, and it's utilizing their CDN. But sometimes I have noticed that their CDN is not that fast, and it is slowing down my website as the images are not loading that fast. So that's why I recommend using Bunny CDN or other CDN if you want to have a more good performance for your website. So if you check right now, let's open a page in my website. You will see that. Let me open this. It has more images. If you check it with the inspect, you will see that CDN shortpixel.ai, it's used to serve this image. And at the end, it will be served via Bunny CDN. So you have the plugin installed. The next thing that you need to do is to log into the bunny.net network and create a new pull zone. I will log in here. Okay, I have this dashboard account, and in the pull zone, just hit add a pull zone. You need to link Bunny CDN with the short pixel domain, so Bunny CDN to know for which this zone it's responsible. And we're gonna do this into this. In here you type your zone name. So I've already created something here. I will use the image zone name. If you want to use this, you have multiple websites, you can use this on multiple websites. So that's why you want maybe to add a generic name if you don't want to use it only in one website. So I will create the image zone here. In here you need to add this detail. You need to add the no CDN AI in here. So this is the link, no dash CDN dot shortpixel.ai, and in this way shortpixel and bunny CDN will know to serve the images for you. Okay, we let the standard tier like this, and then we just hit add zone. So right now the zone it's added. We don't need to do anything in here. If you go to overview, you see that the image zone it's here. It's like this, it's enabled, it has SSL. So right now what you need to do is just to copy this from here. This is the host name for the zone. You see here like host name and origin URL for this. Right now it doesn't have any requests or anything because it's a new one. And we we go and replace the details into behavior. We just replace the host name in here with the new one that we've created. So HTTPS image zone dot b slash cdn dot net slash SPAI, and then we just hit save changes. We clear the CSS cache, that's to be cleared. I will also clear the CDN cache on my website. And right now, if we're gonna refresh this, we should see the image served via Bunny CDN. So if you check in here like source, you will see that the ShortPixel image is not there anymore. You have the image zone dot b dash cdn dot net. So right now all the images that exist on the website will be served via Bunny CDN. If we check another one, you'll see the same thing in here. So that's all you need to do to configure your Bunny CDN with the ShortPixel adaptive image. It's not hard, it's easy, and this can help you speed up your WordPress website. If you don't have a Bunny.net subscription, you can get a trial for 14 days right now to try this. If you check here, I have this for about 1 year. It cost me more than less than $1 a month. You see here the usage, it's very low. I'm using this for multiple websites, and it helps me speed up my WordPress website. So that's all. If that's all you need to do to configure this into your adaptive image. Thanks for watching this video. If you have any questions, please drop a comment in the video. If you like the video, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching this video, and see you next time.